So winter has finally arrived in central Ontario with the snow and the cold weather, and it just feels like hockey season now. And with that, let's take a look at some of the news items from around the Ontario Hockey League. Although two out of these three news items involve the Barrie Colts. So let's get right into it. It has been confirmed that Brendan Sarrazotti will not be joining the Barrie Colts. Sarrazotti, he was acquired from the Sioux Greyhounds in the trade that sent Jacob Frasca up north to join the Greyhounds. And Sarrazotti, he's had a decent season with the Greyhounds, 14 goals, 14 assists, good for 28 points in 38 games. So for the Barrie Colts, looking to have some scoring and to stay competitive in the Eastern Conference, but they won't have the services of Sarrazotti. Coming into today, the Colts right now 4 points back of the Peterborough Petes for that final playoff spot. So what is being reported is that he informed the Greyhounds that he would not report to the Barrie Colts. However, that information was not passed on to General Manager Marty Williamson. This was posted, of course, by Jean Pereira over on X, and he mentioned it during the broadcast on Saturday. So for Williams, he says that Sirazadi is going to school. So that's the reason he's given for not coming to the Barrie Colts. And Marty Williamson also asking the league to look into the situation to see if anything can be done in regards to compulsory picks or whatnot. So we'll have to wait and see how this transpires. It's kind of a he said kind of situation. So we'll have to wait and see what happens. But it is a big loss for the Barrie Colts. As I mentioned, they're in the middle of battling for that final playoff spot in the Eastern Conference. Sirazadi would have been fantastic up front just to kind of provide that offensive spark that the Colts need, considering he has those 14 goals. But it is kind of a tough situation. You're in your final year in the Ontario Hockey League. You're playing with a team that's first place in the West Division. And then at the OHL trade deadline, you get traded to the team fighting for their playoff lives. So I understand where Brendan Sarrazotti is coming from. But at the same time, if he told the Greyhounds that he wasn't going to report, but they still completed the trade without passing that information on, that's kind of questionable. Although, who knows? So the Ontario Hockey League, we'll have to wait and see if they'll, in fact, investigate. And then we'll see what comes from that. So that's the situation. Brendan Sarrazotti has not been in the Barrie Colts lineup, and don't expect him in the lineup anytime soon. Although they still have him on the roster. So if he does change his mind, the Barrie Colts would have a position for Sarrazotti. Now, the other news affecting the Barrie Colts is the sound system malfunction at the Saddlin Arena. Before Saturday's game, their audio system had a technical issue. There was suddenly this buzz that was going on. It almost sounded like an alarm just before the warm-ups. So it seems like a speaker may have blown or something to do with that. So the Colts, they did post on social media a couple of tweets, or they put out a few messages on X about the situation and wondering when the city of Barrie is going to come through with the new sound system, because it was different. So no music during the warmups. There was no national anthem because there was a recording. There was an elementary school that was supposed to perform, so they couldn't perform that night. So they actually had the crowd sing the national anthem, although it seemed like there was a little confusion with the crowd as to how do you start. There was no one really starting it, so it was a tough situation, but the fans made good. It was kind of neat hearing the fans sing "O Canada" before the game. But then during the game, you didn't have any of the announcements, like the final minute of the play, who scored the goals, telling us what the penalties were, until the end of the second period when the system finally came back online and they were able to finish the game with the proper sound. But Mayor Alex Nuttall for the city of Barrie, he was at the game, and he was entertaining the mayor of Brantford. It was the Bulldogs who were in town. So the mayor of Brantford and some city councilors from his community were at the Saddlin Arena to take a look at the site, because right now Brantford in the process of planning a new arena. They want to build a 5,000-seat arena, so getting some ideas about what works, maybe some ways to improve. And I think the sound system may have been a topic of discussion, I'm sure, between the two mayors. But Alex Nuttall, the mayor of Barrie, saying that the city will, in fact, look into it. The sound system was already in the works. They're planning to do that during the off-season, so they had money set aside in the budget. But this just comes as the Barrie Colts, their lease at the Saddlin Arena expires at the end of February. They did sign a one-year lease last year because there's just been ongoing negotiations between the city and the OHL team. There have been things in the media about what's going on, but I'm not going to get into it here because I think that's just yeah, we can keep that on the outside. But so still the big thing, the audio system had the technical issue. The city is planning to install a new sound system this summer, but still made for a very unique situation over the weekend between the Colts and the Bulldogs. And finally, I just wanted to touch on this because the news broke Saturday that Cody Hodgson, the former Brampton Battalion, he's looking to make a comeback in hockey. It won't necessarily be at the National Hockey League level. You may remember Cody Hodgson, he was drafted 10th overall by the Vancouver Canucks, and he had to cut his career short due to a rare muscle disorder. That was back in 2016. So it was really too bad because Cody Hodgson has so much potential. He was great with that Brampton Battalion team in 2009. They went all the way to the OHL Championship when they lost to the Windsor Spitfires. It was a fantastic run. Hodgson and Matt Duchene were on that team. It was a lot of fun. I even got to go to a few of those games. You know, all the best to Cody Hodgson. He was given that clean bill of health. He's been on the ice 5 to 6 times a week trying to get his game legs back, and we'll see where he ends up. So hopefully Hodgson will be successful in his hockey comeback. He is 34 years of age, so I'm sure for him it'll take a little bit more time and practice, but I'm sure a team will give him that opportunity. So those are the news items from around the Ontario Hockey League today. Let me know in the comments section down below your thoughts on any of these news items, and don't forget to hit like and subscribe, and we'll talk to you again soon.